The Objective News Network. Healthcare in America. What's the real problem? Hello, this is John Nasher reporting for the Objective News Network. Thank you for joining us. Today, we are going to talk about the lingering and growing problem of high cost and low quality healthcare in America. In the U.S., we use a fee-for-service model. Fee-for-service means that medical staff bill you for each service provided using established billing codes. The more care a physician provides, the more money they're paid. The longer they treat you, the more money they make. Fee-for-service is a Tayloristic notion, where efficiency is measured by reducing the number of work units required to make or do something, and reducing costs per unit by mass production to make whatever the product you're selling affordable to everyone. So let's start off by looking at the numbers and asking ourselves how well the current fee-for-service healthcare model is working for America. Well, the United States spends more on healthcare than any other high-income country in the world, but still has the lowest life expectancy at birth and the highest rate of people with multiple chronic diseases. According to a new report from the Commonwealth Fund, an independent research group, one of the most pressing issues in healthcare is, of course, the high cost of care. More than 45% of American adults say it's difficult to afford health care, according to a survey by the Kaiser Family Foundation, and more than 40% have medical debt. The United States healthcare system is market-driven. High, unregulated prescription drug costs and healthcare providers' salaries rank higher than in most other Western nations, and hospital care accounts for a whopping 31% of the nation's overall healthcare costs. The problem of the pandemic highlighted one of the most serious issues in healthcare, the provider shortage. Another one of the largest contributors to the high cost of healthcare is wasteful spending, which accounts for $765 billion with a B, dollars a year. In addition to all this, the healthcare industry has long noted the vast disparities in healthcare outcomes between different populations of our society. At this point, I think we can safely conclude that the current healthcare system in the U.S. is not working very well, and the prospects for getting any better as the population continues to age doesn't look very promising either. So, if what you are doing hasn't worked in the past and there's little hope for the future, then why don't we just fix the system and be done with it? Well, the real answer is pretty straightforward. There's a great deal of money that comes out of the current but very broken system that goes directly to profit-making industries like the pharmaceutical industry and healthcare insurance providers. Thus, many of these businesses have a vested interest in maintaining the status quo, broken or not. But at the very heart of the problem is that the traditional fee-for-service model that treats human beings like a commodity that can be administered just like you would take care of a car may not be the best approach. If the tire on your car goes flat, you go to the garage and get it fixed for an established per unit cost, including labor and the cost of a new tire and taxes. But taking care of human beings is much more complex than a car. If something breaks on a human being, you can't be sure if it will be fixed at a predetermined time and at any predetermined per unit cost. Every person is different, except for one thing: the value we place on an individual life in our society, which we all profess is priceless. The situation, of course, does not lend itself to any meaningful way to tayloristically analyze using actuarial science to understand human biology and the uncertainties of human wellness in America. With that said, let's take a very quick look at some of the proposed solutions out there. Well, I don't think any of us will be surprised at the vast majority of homegrown solutions proposed to solve the problem. Almost all of them call for fixes of the various little parts of an existing but broken system. So let's go back to the car analogy for a second. If you've got an old car with a frame that has been completely rusted away, then why do you keep changing the tires? Maybe the solutions to the healthcare crisis involve taking a look around the world at places like Norway, Sweden, and Australia. In Australia, for example, they have put together one of the best healthcare systems on the globe by recognizing that the good health of an individual from birth to death is a complex matter that is not subject to the certainties of actuarial analysis. In Australia, they have created a sort of hybrid model that takes the types of things that government does best and combines them with the things that private industry does best. Perhaps fixing our healthcare system in America means looking around us to learn what works and what doesn't work in other countries of the world. It is what it is for April 28, 2023. This is John Hnatio reporting for the Objective News Network. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to seeing you the next time.